Hello, this is Tytti Vanhala, Associate Trainer for Art2Ride. This is a second submission from Cherisse and her horse Charlie. The first submission she sent us in November, and unfortunately, later on in early December, Charlie sustained an unknown injury, which resulted in severe back pain. So Cherisse gave him a month off and then started gently working him again. And apparently he still has issues with back pain, but the vet has not been able to determine the cause as yet. But apparently some mild anti-inflammatories seem to help, and the vet had prescribed them for a period and advised her to keep on working to strengthen his back during this time. But I don't know if you have had the vet to check his gelding scar yet. If not, I would really urge you to ask them to check it. Because if the gelding scar is really hard and tight, it will affect the normal locomotion of the horse and cause compensatory movement patterns. And that, in turn, may lead to all kinds of problems, of which back pain is just one. So do have a check on that. If you already haven't done it, that is. Okay, but let's get back to the present submission then. When I first viewed this video, I thought immediately how much better he looks and moves. Truly, I mean, your in-hand work has improved so immensely. It's really well done on that. Previously, you tended to walk past his shoulder, but now you stay really nicely in position at the shoulder, and your hands are so much better positioned as well. So now your hands are more following his head, and you're not really pulling backwards or downwards with your inside hand anymore, and your outside hand stays in the position at the shoulder. So that's all really, really good. And I can see that you have been practicing and taking all the advice that I gave you earlier, and it really has paid off, as you can see here. I had also commented earlier that you should keep to a much bigger circle or go around the whole arena with the in-hand work, and you do it really well here as well. And overall, I think he's working very well in hand now. And your work here is flowing very nicely indeed. So there isn't any stopping and going anymore, like before, nor is he slowing down way too much anymore, like he used to. And here you can really see how much his stretching has improved. It's now coming all the way from the withers to his poll, and he's really extending his neck outwards and forwards, as well as down. And I think as I said your position is really improved, and you're actually here, you can see how nicely you and the horse give each other enough space, so he's not leaning into you and you're not really pushing into him, and you're just nicely walking beside each other. And there you could really see a beautiful, beautiful stretch you had there. And it immediately helped with the work through his back. And you could see how nicely his hocks were bending a lot more just there when you passed the door opening. And here when he brings his head a little bit higher, you just take a little bit more contact. I can see your hands are keeping the contact. So that's really good. That's very good work. And I think the pace that you have here is pretty optimal most of the time. Sometimes he gets a little bit slow, but it's mainly when he's really stretching all the way down, and that is actually okay. So it's okay for him to slow down ever so little when he's at really the lowest stretch, because it is, after all, difficult to really engage those back muscles and the top line altogether. But you can see there as well, he was really relaxing into the stretch, and his head is starting to kind of bob around with the movement, and he's really relaxing into it. So that's really good work. So I think the pace, so his pace is really improved, because last time he was just too slow. He wasn't really going anywhere. But here you can see how his hind legs are working much better. So he's really striding better, and he feels a lot more relaxed over his top line in total. So I wonder if he was a little bit uncomfortable and stiff still in the previous submission compared to now. And obviously all the work you've done has helped really well, because here you can really see that lovely stretch all the way from the withers. So that is very good work for him. So I don't think you need to ask him to move any faster than he does just now here with the in-hand work. I think this is really pretty optimal for him, because you want to have a look at the hind legs, how well they stride. And if you compare it to your previous submission, he was far more hastier with his stride and it was shorter, whereas now it's far more flowing and it's the stride is much bigger, definitely. So this is an improvement, even though you had the difficulties, and even though you had to stop for work for some weeks. So that's very good. And here we see, actually, you said the last time that you had difficulties in stopping him, and well, this is certainly a huge improvement in that as well, that he has learned to stop and wait for you, and is very calm and doesn't get stressed about stopping and changing the rein, so to say. So that's excellent as well. So even though he has been injured in the meanwhile, you have still advanced with your own technique and also his training, because he looks so much better in this video. And he's so much more relaxed, and you are so much more confident in what you're doing. So that's excellent. Really good. And here, when he passes here, you can really see how much he overtracks in the walk, in the stretch. That is a very good thing to see. Obviously, though, how much the horse overtracks is really individual. And of course, in some cases, the horse needs to really overtrack a lot to use his back properly. So it really depends on conformation of the horse as well, this how much the overtracking is influencing the horse's back. But this is really, this is very good to see, that he's stepping under himself so much more here. And here you're asking a nice small leg yield, just here, just a couple of slight yield steps there. And I think he really performed it in a very good and relaxed way, and furthermore in a stretch. So this is a huge improvement to your last submission, when he just stopped altogether and he didn't quite know what to do when you were asking for the sideways movement. But this is exactly how you should start it, very gradually, just a step or two sideways, and that's exactly good. And the fact that he's relaxed and stretching in the yield, this will really activate the back muscles even further. So great work on that. And actually, I think you could start doing a little bit more yield still. But just keep it indeed as gradual as you have done here. But you can slowly increase the amount you do. So slightly more sideways and a little bit longer yields. But also keep an eye on his comfort levels and what he can do and adapt to it, as I think you have done very well here, because he stays nice and relaxed and he's stretching so nicely. It's really, as I've said, this in-hand work is a huge improvement over the months that you have done it now. And here again, such a nice stop, such a huge difference to what it was before. You said in your letter that you did walk before you started trotting here. So for everybody else to know that, yes, she did walk, but it just got left out from the video. And he was a little bit tense also in the walk, apparently. And you can see that he's a little bit tense in this trot, and he's not really stepping through very well. His stride length is a lot less than it was in the in-hand work. You can very clearly see how much stiffer this is. So, and I think this overall, the lunging work is pretty much the same as I saw last time. So it is a bit varied. So he gets to really good places at times, but then he also stiffens up and lifts his head too high for him. But on the other hand, having said that, I think he does work better over his back. So I can see his back is moving more now than it did then, especially in the walk work, which you do. But later on also, you can really see the back starting to move, even in the trot. Even if it's a little bit varied with the quality. So this trot here is a little bit on the edge of not being useful. And it kind of, every time his head goes down, you can see the hocks here immediately start to bend more, and he can step a little bit better. But at the same time, he cannot maintain the forward rhythm as much, or the activity level, so to say. So he slows down ever so slightly too much. And I know you have difficulties in keeping him going, and that is the difficulty in any case, is to find the line between optimal activity and too slow or too fast. And as you say, when you encourage him to pick up the pace a little bit, he tends to poke his head up then and stiffen. So he's obviously finding it a bit difficult still to do this trot work, especially on the left rein. On the right rein, later on, you can really see the difference between the two sides. He finds it definitely a lot easier to work on his right rein rather than left. And that was the same last time, as I observed. But I think indeed, as I said earlier, that his back is moving more. And I think it may be indeed due to the in-hand work, because it is far more effective now than it was a couple of months ago. So that's definitely helping a lot. So it is it is very varied still, the work, and it's no wonder if he has had that time off and he still has had problems with the back pain, and that would all influence it, of course. And you also said that you did mainly walk work for several weeks after you restarted. So that's definitely the way to do it, just very gently, especially if you still think that there could be some pain related still in the back. But yeah, I do think that he moves better. He looks more supple, so to say, through his top line. Even when his head is like this high, he seems to be moving better, and especially now in this walk, he's a lot better. Obviously, when his head goes down more, he's immediately moving again a little bit better. I would suggest for you to start walking with him in as big a circle as possible in the school. You could be a lot closer to him as well than what you are now. Let's say like a whip's length away from him. So you would walk with him in a big circle and aim at the same level of work as you get in the in-hand work. And you can use your whip as a cue for him to yield just a tad with his shoulder or his hind end. So, and obviously with yielding here, I mean just that he gives way to you, not necessarily that he steps actually across at all, but just bending a little bit more on the circle. You can aim at the whip where your leg would go when you ride. That would be around the girth area. That will distinguish the yield command from forward driving command, which is then pointing or using the whip at the end of the buttocks. When you keep the contact to him with the lunge line at the same time as you ask him to yield slightly from him, that should induce him to stretch down. So it's the same kind of cues as you would give in the in-hand work, except that you translate it to the lunging work that you do in walk. So you would aim at good activity, ever so slight a yield, keep the contact, and he should respond by lowering the head and relaxing to the work. Once he does all that, you should just relax all your aids so that he knows that he's doing the right thing. And when his head goes up, you would just repeat it again. You can even add in a voice command for yield, and maybe eventually you only need to point at the girth area and use the voice command for him to react to your aids. And so when you are this close to him, you will have a far more control over his work level. And when you get him working well over his back in the walk on the lunge, then the trot should actually become a lot easier. I say here should, since I did say earlier that when you get the in-hand work going well, that would revolutionize your lunging as well. But, well, of course he did have that injury, and that would affect, of course, everything. And I still do think the improvement in the in-hand work is going to have a positive impact on the lunging work as well. So aim at improving this walk work that you do here. It's not bad, but indeed it could be a lot more efficient, and I think you will get it more efficient if you are slightly bit closer to him in that. But he does give you some really nice stretches here, and he's stretching again all the way from his withers here. So that is a good thing. I can see that when you encourage him to move more actively, he pokes his head up. But like there is a nice stretch there, and that is not too slow either. That activity level is okay, and you stopped in a very nice moment there as well. So on the right side we see you do the walk work before the trot work, as you did also with the on the left side, but we just did not see it done before the trot work. And as you can all see, he does work so much better on this right hand. And here you can see a really fantastic stretch. You can see how the movement goes through his whole top line. And even though the pace looks a little bit slow, it actually isn't too slow, because you can still see the nice big stride from behind and the muscles working here again. Very nice, very good work that. So every time he goes with his head low like that, with nose poking out, and that's excellent. That will work so well with for him. I don't quite remember if he was as good as that in your previous submission, but this is definitely, that type of walk work is good, and this kind of work you should really maximize with that work closer to him on the lunge line, and try to really maximize that kind of work in the lower stretch and him stepping under more efficiently. The trot work on the right hand side, as ever, you can see it's so much better than on the left hand, and you can see how he's relaxing and stretching from his withers again. He's in the beginning here, he's still a little bit short from behind, but you can see here already an improvement after about a circle or two. So this side definitely is working better. And if you feel that he works in general a lot better on the right hand side, I think you could start your lunging on the right hand side, so that he gets more suppled up and more warmed up easier on that easier right hand side, so to say. And then the work on the left side, if that is the more difficult side in general, then that work will be easier for him, because he's already warmed up through his body. But yeah, there are a couple of really nice stretches, and you can see that his back is starting to move. So the muscles along his back are activating, definitely. So he's using his top line muscles here. It just not is very consistent yet. However, he is stretching down, and I can see his back and his top line muscles are moving in the right way. So he is building his top line muscles even with this work. You just need to optimize it more and get him working longer in that optimal position for him. And I think actually this pace in this trot work here has been pretty good just before you came back to walk for a while there. So that was pretty good work in trot in the end. And the walk here is a nice break from the trot work, but it's not that terribly good actually, but you go back to trot anyway pretty soon here. So here again, after the walk, you can see that he's quite short strided from behind, and when his head is high, but immediately, even when his head is going just below the withers or around his knees, you can see how much more he can step under already at that position. So like there, he's starting to be much, much better looking. And then in occasion he just loses the concentration and gets a little bit short. But then again, he comes back to a bit nicer stretch and nicer stride from behind. But it's still very obvious that it is hard work for him to step under properly with the stretch. So again, as I said earlier, it's a bit varied work, but there's loads of good moments like there, with nice stretches, and that he's really starting to use his hocks better and more, and he's stepping under better. And you can see his back is moving. You can see that quite clearly, especially on this right hand side. You can see his back starting to move, and even a little bit of wave coming at through it every now and then. So he's still suppling up through his back, even though he has that underlying back pain issue still going on. And I hope that you will eventually find out what is causing that, and you can move on from that then again. What I would also like to point out is that he's actually bending very nicely on the circle here. As you can see here, as he comes around, just before you go to walk, you can see how he's bending laterally on the circle. So he's definitely not straight, or he's not incredibly stiff actually in this work. So that's a good sign as well, that he's able to bend through his body on the circle. And I think you came back to walk in the right moment, and his back muscles are really working quite nicely there. The pace is maybe a little bit slow there, but I think it's pretty good work for him anyway. And considering that this is the end part of your session, it's I think that's fine. And also, he's still stepping quite nicely under himself, so he's got a lovely flowing longer stride from behind here. Even if his head is a little bit too high, he's stepping a lot nicer than in the beginning. So you're kind of approaching the work level that you had with the in-hand work, with the flowing stride here in the end. So you may feel discouraged, and you may be questioning yourself in regards to the training, but what I can see is that you have really improved your technique a lot, and I think you're doing the best you can for your horse with this work that you're doing now. And as you said yourself as well, he started well below zero line, so to say, and he has also had that injury to slow down the process further. So I can truly fully understand your frustration when the training seems not to proceed as quickly as optimally as you would like, or you had envisioned it to go. Well, also, I think once you find out what is the underlying cause to the back pain he's experiencing, you will have a kind of a more precise plan on how to tackle it, and hopefully that will then resolve the issue eventually. Okay, well, this walk here is again a little bit varied. I think you're asking there for a bit more activity every now and then, and he's reacting by lifting his head a little bit up and higher and losing the stretch. So you're here, as we were discussing in the Facebook group of fans and followers, it is a very, very fine line between the optimal activity level and then too much or too little. And here you can see it happening actually, that here is sometimes a little bit too much activity in the walk, and then there's too little. And as you can see here, he went into trot because he couldn't maintain the level of good work in the walk. So he just went into a faster pace instead, which was trot, obviously. So as you see here, he's again lifting his head a little bit higher because he can't maintain that level of activity with the stretch. And here he had couple of nice short stretches there with good stepping under. So the activity is obviously crucial, but too much is too much. If the horse can't cope with the activity level and the stretch, then you just have to compromise for a little while and just let him be a little slower for a while and gradually ask for a little bit more activity. So to summarize, I think your best work at the moment is in the in-hand, where he can step under the best and he looks very comfortable doing it as well. So your challenge is then to translate that level of work into the lunging as well. So keep up the good work, and I hope to see a submission soon again. Bye!